Shalom. First of all, I want to give all praises to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem, Recha Kodash, and double honors to the elders and apostles at Great Millstone who rule well. Peace and salutation to all sincere Achim, and of course, that are fighting and risking their freedom to bring out the Samath, which is the truth of the Bible. Of course, Yahweh being the true name of the Heavenly Father, who the world ignorantly calls God, and his only begotten Son's name is Yahweh Shai, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. That, of course, is their pure names in the Paleo-Hebrew. Bahashem meaning in the name. Recha meaning spirit. And Kodash is holy. Brother Mappa, Great Millstone, Playing Tables Camp. Coming again with another lesson due to Recha Kodash, the Holy Spirit. It's off theguardian.com. It says, does the banning of Alex Jones signal a new era of big tech responsibility? With the removal of conspiracy theorist material from key platforms, firms have changed their tune on free speech. Some see the move as more about money than morality. It says here, at this very moment, the conspiracy theorist Alex Jones almost certainly sitting in the front of a camera shouting that he has been silenced. Now, of course, you have to understand that this conspiracy theorist, you know, when you go into it, this term, most people, they deem it as something very negative. But when you go into it, most of these conspiracies are actually of truth, all right? And they're not just mere imagination, okay, that someone just thinks up and they're crazy, okay? As they say, theorists, it says a person concerned with the theatrical aspects of a subject, conspiracy, when I go into it, this is just a basic definition. It says a secret plan by a group to do something unlawful or harmful. Example, a conspiracy to destroy the government. In which you have to understand that the government and all that you see here today is being controlled by the so-called white man, the elite of them who are all Edomites. When you get the understanding, those Rothschilds, those Rockefellers, those DuPonts, the name, some of them, those elite banking families, they are the wicked that the Bible speak of, the secret council. They, of course, have an agenda in which they are going to try to accomplish, but the Most High Yahweh Bashem Yahshai is going to bring them down. And you have guys like Alex Jones, in which he's an insider. He, of course, have a website called InfoWars in which they are deeming a lot of his content as hate speech and such. And really, this is the age of all truth and deceit being quenched, in which now we see everything being exposed and brought to the light, which I'm going to go into my first precept. This is Psalm 64:8, and it reads, so they shall make their own tongue to fall upon themselves. All that see them shall flee away. And who is that? The so-called white man we're speaking of. Their own tongue is falling upon themselves because they are, of course, bringing about truths about their own nation. You know, with Alex Jones, he's an Edomite. He's from the nation of Edom, which Edom means, of course, Adawam in the Hebrew, which means red. And they are, of course, the wicked, and they're the devil of the Bible. They're the deceivers. And through these Edomites and some of these Edomites, these so-called truthers and such, they, of course, are bringing out a lot of wicked plots in which the the devil, the elites of them at least, of the Edomites, have in store for the entire planet Earth, all right? But most especially to bring down the nation of Yashal of Israel, which consists of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and the Americans, which you are the Lord's chosen people. I'm going to go to another scripture. This is the book of Luke, the 16th chapter. And let me see if this is the right one. It's actually another scripture. Give me one moment. Let me retrieve it. This is Ezekiel 28:3. Behold, thou art wiser than Daniel. There is no secret that they can hide from thee. Which, you know, you had the so-called white man. Of course, Daniel, he's a prophet. And these so-called white men, they, of course, do them searching out iniquity and such. They're wise, you know. A lot of them, of course, are hip to what is, you know, what who actually we are, you know, and some of these prophecies and such, all right? And, most of us have been woken up. A lot of these Edomites, they knew that we're Israelites, and they knew a lot of these different things that are going to happen. That the Heavenly Father is going to come back and et cetera, all right? But not to get off topic too much, I'm going to go back to the actual article, which I actually have several different links. So it says, anyway, it says, of course, Alex Jones, he said that he's being silenced, right? If you are so inclined, you can easily watch and listen along either by going to his website, downloading his iPhone and Android apps, or follow him on Twitter. What you can no longer do as of Monday is consume Jones' toxic brew of lies, hate, and product placement. His own term for this is InfoWars via Facebook, YouTube, or Spotify. After Apple decided to stop distributing Jones' podcasts on Sunday, and it says the other powerful online distribution platforms swiftly following the suit. So you have, of course, these different platforms in which you have this man, of course, Alex Jones, who's an Edomite, used to, of course, spread, bringing out, of course, a lot of different truths and such. Some truth that he mentioned, of course, is about a race war, a coming, like a second civil war, in which that was, of course, prophesied in the Bible to happen, is will happen. You know, you see movies like The Purge, that, of course, will be a reality, and that, of course, is written in the scriptures and such. All right, just a quick one. This is Second Esdras, the 15th chapter, and verse 15, it says, for the sword in their destruction, and if you read up above, it says, woe to the world and them that dwell therein, for the sword in their destruction draw nigh, and one people shall stand up and fight against another, and swords in their hand, for there shall be sedition among men, and evading one another, they shall not regard their kings nor their princes, and the course of their action shall stand in their power. So, of course, there's going to be a race war that's going to happen, all right? You're going to have people, of course, going against the current king of Great Babylon, being Donald Trump, their different government leaders and such, and against each other, okay? You go into this word, sedition. It means a rebel, all right, against the authority of a state or monarch, all right? So you're going to have that, you know, which is going to bring forth civil disorder and chaos, all right? Ardo al-Kale, all right? Which that, of course, is going to happen here on the planet Earth, especially here in America. Now, going back to the article, One moment, I keep switching around. It says, Jones has desperately attempted to frame his deplatforming as the First Amendment violation, which, of course, when you go into the First Amendment, that, of course, is dealing with freedom of press, freedom of speech, just to name some. All right. Going on, it says, but those who invoke the specter of a slippery slope towards authoritarian censorship distract from true significance of this moment, that we are at the inflection point in the way internet platforms conceive a public discourse for society at large. The banishment of InfoWars followed the excruciating long period of pervocation by Facebook and YouTube, which this term pervocation, it means a statement that derives from or perverts the truth. All right, in which when you go into it, you know, these elite, you know, of the so-called white men, you know, they, of course, are running scared currently. All of this information is coming out, exposing them, in which they are, for the lack of terms, they're calling for a lot of different things to occur, such as, say, a guy like that Alex Jones, you know, to be, you know, taken off of these different social media platforms, okay? Which they think is going to suppress more truth. But, you know, as the scriptures say, you can do nothing against the truth before the truth. All right. Which really the truth is coming out by the way of the prophets that are there on the highways and hedges, which, of course, also are putting out and publishing this word on the internet, on the unicorn. Okay. In which there's going to be a time in which this Amoth, which is the truth, is going to be not found on the internet and such, because they're going to shut it down and such. And we're seeing, you know, like this guy, Alex Jones, that's just an early stage of this famine of word and such, you know, being that, you know, using a guy like Alex Jones, you know, he's bringing out some truths and such. Well, we bring out the whole truth, you know, the truth of the Bible, which have all the truth, you know, the script of the entire world, okay? That the so-called white man is a devil in his system is going down, all right? It's going to be a nuclear war. It's going to be a World War III. That's all in the Bible, in the scriptures, all right? So we're going to go into that prophecy. This is Amos 8 and 11, and it reads, "Behold, the days cometh, saith the Lord, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, nor a thirst of water, but of the hearing of the words of Yahweh." So there's going to be that time when there's going to be a famine, all right? You know, it's going to be a time in which there's going to be a lack of this this word, you know, which is very precious and true, and something that, of course, you're going to need for the coming times that are ahead, when, of course, this society breaks down and there is that civil war, that race war, that when that RFID microchip is implemented, which is the mark of the beast. This is another scripture in which I have. This is Ezekiel, the third chapter and the 26th verse, because this is gonna happen, you know. The Lord is gonna shut up His prophets. All right, this is here, Ezekiel 3 and 26. It says, "And I will make thy tongue cleave to the roof of thy mouth, that thou shalt be dumb." All right, somebody who's dumb, they of course they can't of course speak. All right, it says, "In doubt," it's like it says, "insult not be to them a reprover, for they are a rebellious house. And who's that? We're talking about the house of Israel, you know, who are, of course, a very rebellious house, meaning that they make war, they're hard-headed, they're fighting against the Heavenly Father, because they refuse to return, to their heritage, that they're Israelites, and they don't want to receive the correction. You know, they don't want to be in order. But the elect, of course, they, of course, are returning to him, Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. But the two-thirds of Israel, they're just going to get destroyed, all right? They're not going to listen, even, you know, in that time, of course, of the famine of the word and such, and this place being utterly brought down. It says, verse 27, "But when I speak with thee, I will open thy mouth, and thou shalt say unto them, Thus said the Lord Yahweh, He that heareth, let him hear, and he that forbeareth, let him forbear, for there is a rebellious host." And, you know, it's, you know, we of course prophesy, meaning to speak before, and it's, you know, regardless of who gonna listen or not, you know. Like I said, this is only for, of course, the elect of Israel, all right, the first fruits and such. So, you know, we don't care if you guys can't see, you know, the whole script, you know, the whole picture that this is gonna happen, the things that were written in the scriptures. All right, so, you know, I just wanted to make a quick point that, you know, this crackdown on, as they say, conspiracy theorist Alex Jones, because of violence, him promoting violence and hate speech. This is, something that's going to happen to, of course, us being the true men of the Lord who really teach the truth. All right, it's gonna be that famine of that word. All right, you know, slach here for not having, you know, much words. This is just what Yahweh Shem Yashah has going on, got me saying, speaking at this time. All right, yeah, they're just gonna deem it as hate content, simple as that. With that, you can read, of course, I'll leave the links in the description box. Until the next time, I say, call Halayim La Yahweh Bashem Yashai, Bahashem Rachakodash, and double honor to the elders and apostles at Great Millstone. Well, Shalom.